Because if you start with a big sheet, you can cut triangles and not waste any material. Well, if you just want to make these shapes and not waste material, you can pack them together pretty close, and then you save 20%. Now, just think, material savings are like millions of watts are cooler to make every year. It's going to solve global warming, and chocolate melting, and fun. Okay, a different kind of folding problem is linkage folding. So there's a big problem, big challenge in the 1800s, which was how to draw a straight line. Now, you may have learned how to draw a straight line in grade school. The challenge here is to turn a circular crank and make some other device or pen move automatically along a straight line perfectly. So it's all sorts of applications, like moving your candle around. No, the real application here is in locomotive engines. You have a piston which is going along a linear motion, and you have wheels which you want to turn in a circular motion. So how do you convert linear to circular motion? And there are a bunch of ways covered in this great book, How to Draw a Straight Line, which is available on Google Books for free. And here are a couple of them I'll show you. This one is by a guy named Watt. You may have heard of him. He's a unit. And he did a lot of amazing things, but he was most proud of this linkage, which you pin the ends, and it's the blue things are rigid bars. They're moving around in two dimensions. And that green dot moves along the red figure eight. And in the middle here, it's almost straight. Not quite straight, but close. Whereas these guys are moving around in circles. So that's pretty good. And this changed the landscape of steam engines. The first correct solution, or perfect solution, is found 100 years later by this guy, Poisson. Now we have another unit here, Lord Kelvin. And he was playing around with one of these made out of wood, and someone was saying, can I try? He said, no, I've not had nearly enough of it. It's the most beautiful thing I've seen in my life. How times have changed. It's before the YouTube video. In fact, you can do much more. You can make a linkage, one of these mechanical devices, turn a circular crank, and trace out any smooth curve you want. You can sign your name with a very complicated linkage. It's fun. This is, in some sense, an old result. It goes back to the late 1800s. Very cool. And it is this kind of linkage folding that we use to try to understand how proteins fold. Now, you look at any living creature in the world we live in, you look very close, there's little proteins running around making life happen. They are the fundamental building block of life. We would like to understand how they work. They fold pretty much like one of those linkages, but just in three dimensions instead of two. It makes it a lot harder. But we're trying to take the mathematical tools that we have for understanding how linkages fold, how robotic arms fold, and so on, and apply them to understand how proteins fold, which could potentially lead to new drugs. Some new disease comes out, say, oh, that's tricky. Let's make this protein so it folds into this shape so it'll capture that disease without hurting the human. So that's a lot of fun. It's still ongoing, obviously. You would have heard of these solvents. You can download your designer drugs whenever you need them. But we're using geometry to understand how biology works. We're trying to. Proteins like this guy, is made by this machine called a ribosome. And there's a little protein here in white comes out this tunnel and starts folding. Now when it folds, it's blocked by this big geometric obstacle. And it turns out that just the fact that there's a big obstacle there lets you reason about what kinds of folds you can make. It's pretty fun. All right, the last topic I want to tell you about is hinge dissection. This is kind of like how proteins fold, but now we're instead of understanding how some existing thing folds, we're going to take that idea and exploit it to make our own cool foldings. So this is a hinge dissection. It folds, it's a chain of blocks. It folds into an equilateral triangle or square. You could use this to make a table, depending on whether you have three people or four people. You can adjust. Very practical. And we've been generalizing, well, what other shapes can we make with a hinged chain of blocks? It turns out you can make any letter of the alphabet. You take these 128 blocks, you can fold from M to A to T to H and so on, or fold the numbers, or fold the square. So that's kind of fun. This is a design illustrating a mathematical result. You can generalize that to 3D. So this is a chain of about 1,000 blocks with piano hinges. and it's an interactive sculpture. You pick up the gloves, you can fold it into any shape made out of little cubes. Finally, these are all based on results that we understood for a while, but the big question was, can you do anything? And it turns out the answer is yes. You take any collection of shapes of the same area in 2D or the same volume in 3D, I'm sliding under the rug there, then there's one hinged chain of blocks that can fold into all of these shapes. And you can use this, again, to make transformers. You can build a big chain of blocks, and this lets you make very large structures and solid structures that could be stuck inside here, and it will fold into any 3D structure made out of little blocks that you want. So again, you could have, imagine reconfigurable furniture, reconfigurable buildings, anything. And so it's a lot of fun exploring all these different folding problems from both an art and a science perspective, and that's all.